Hi, my name is Eric Replinger. I'm an instructional designer with the Regis Company, a CDOT training partner. In this video, we'll look at how to prepare record sets and other large project records so they can be signed and sealed using Adobe Sign. This video shows the steps for Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, the document cloud version. If you're using Adobe Acrobat Pro 11, please see the companion video for that version. The techniques are the same, but there are differences in where you find and how you use the tools in each version. In order to sign and seal a document with Adobe Sign, the document must be 50 megabytes or less and 999 pages or less. There are two techniques available to help you meet the file size and page count limits. You may be able to reduce the file size by printing the document to PDF, and you can and probably will need to split the document into multiple parts for signing and sealing, then reassemble the parts into a single portfolio file. Note that if you have Adobe Acrobat Standard, you can split a document into multiple parts, but you will not be able to reassemble the parts into a portfolio file. The portfolio feature is available only in the Pro version. Let's take a look at an example file and see how those techniques work. Here's our record set. The file is 192 megabytes, almost four times Adobe Sign's file size limit of 50 megabytes. And here's the record set opened in Adobe Acrobat. The document has 280 pages, well within Adobe Sign's page limit of 999 pages. If the document's less than about 200 megabytes, you can try printing it to PDF to reduce the file size. If the document's much bigger, Acrobat will probably not be able to print it to PDF. Acrobat's a 32-bit application, which means it can only address a certain amount of memory before it can't handle the file at all. Since this file is 192 megabytes, let's try printing it to PDF and see what happens. Even though this is already a PDF file, printing it to PDF should reduce the file size while keeping the image quality. Start by going to the File menu and selecting Print. That opens the Print dialog. The first thing we need to do is to change the printer from whatever it's currently set at to Adobe PDF. Record sets are 17 inches wide by 11 inches high. Notice that this print preview is showing that the printer will currently print only the center portion of each page. So we need to change the page settings. You can change the page settings manually or let Acrobat adjust them automatically. To change them manually, click Page Setup. From the paper size drop-down, select the 11 by 17 option, and then you can change to the landscape orientation. Cancel that out for a minute. The way to do that automatically is to simply click the button that says Choose Paper Source by PDF Page Size. That will adjust the orientation and the paper size automatically. There's one other change we need to make in order to reduce the file size when we print the file. Click on Properties, and then in the Adobe PDF Settings tab, click on Default Settings. It's currently set to Standard. We want to change that to Standard Classic. This changes the printer settings for compatibility with earlier versions of Acrobat. When I tried printing this record set using the standard setting, the printed file was actually larger than the original file. Changing the setting to Standard Classic resulted in a smaller printed file. Then click OK. When you're done with all the settings, then click Print. I'm going to cancel out of printing the file now because it'll take about 10 minutes to complete. I did print that earlier, so let's take a look at the results. Here's the record set after printing. Notice that the file size has been reduced about 17% from 192 megabytes to 160 megabytes. That's still more than three times Adobe Sign's file size limit of 50 megabytes. So we're going to have to split the document into parts before we can send it for signing and sealing. Should you print a PDF? Is it worth the time and effort? Here's some recommendations based on the file size. Returning to the record set that we printed to PDF, how do we split it into parts? Start by opening the Tools menu on the right side of the page. Then click Organize Pages. And then in the bar at the top, click the Split button. Acrobat assumes that you want to split the document by a number of pages. We need to change that to split it by file size. And it starts with a file size of 2 megabytes. Remember that Adobe Sign needs every file to be 50 megabytes or less. If we set this to 50, it's likely that one or more of the parts will still be slightly over that limit. So let's try setting that to 48 megabytes. Finally, we need to check the output options. For the target folder, if you keep the default setting of the same folder selected at start, Adobe will save the parts to the same folder as the complete file. Or you can click a folder on my computer and then save the parts to any local or network folder that you select. In the file labeling section, you want Acrobat to add a label and a number after the original name. The default label is part, and the default separator character is underscore. So each part will be named using the original name, followed by an underscore, the word part, and the number of the part. Click OK when you're done reviewing or changing these settings. When you're done with the settings, click the split button. And I'm going to cancel out of that as well because it'll take about 30 or 40 seconds for that to complete. I did split it earlier, so let's take a look at the result. Here are the four parts, three at roughly 48 megabytes each, the remainder at 16 megabytes. Here's part one. Notice that it has 54 pages. Starting at page one, going to sheet one, and going to sheet 54. And part two has 70 pages, starting at sheet 55 and going to sheet 124. The file size for each page depends on the contents of the page, so the parts are likely to have a different number of pages. That's all there is to splitting the file, splitting a large document into parts. Now you can use Adobe Sign to prepare and send each part in the automated workflow for signing and sealing. How do we put our sealed documents back together into a single file, the way they were before we broke them apart? Acrobat does have an option to combine multiple files into a single PDF, but that option will not maintain the signature authenticity that we need. Instead, we're going to create something called a portfolio. An Acrobat portfolio is a container that can hold various types of documents. It can hold Word documents, Excel files, PDFs, and so on. And most importantly, in the case of sealed documents, the portfolio also maintains the authenticity of the signatures. You can learn more about portfolios on the Adobe website, as shown here. To create the portfolio, start by opening Acrobat. I've already got it open, but I'm going to close the files that we've been working with. And I'm going to prepare my desktop to make this workflow easier. In case you're not familiar with it, a very helpful Windows keyboard shortcut is to combine the Window key, that's the key with the Windows logo at the lower left of your keyboard, with the left or the right arrow. Pressing the Windows key plus the right arrow will resize Acrobat to use the right half of the screen. Pressing the Windows key plus the left arrow will resize File Explorer to use the left half of the screen. Now in Acrobat, from the File menu, select Create, and then the option for Portfolio. Remember that you only see this option if you have Acrobat Pro. The option to create a portfolio is not available in Acrobat Standard. You can browse and select files, but it's usually easier and more reliable to drag and drop them, so that's why I resized the windows so that we can see them both. We want to select our four files, make sure that they're all in the correct order. You can do that by just grabbing them all, or you can click one and then press Control and A for all. Select those. They're in the correct order, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now I'm just going to drag them over here into the Create PDF Portfolio window. There they are. We can take a look and make sure that they're still in the right order. And then click the Create button. This is a pretty quick process. And we're done. I'm going to maximize Acrobat. And here we have the portfolio. The four icons on the left are the documents. We can click each one and move to the next document. Previewing them on the right as we do that. If somehow these have ended up out of order, you could drag and drop them into a different order in this view. So our portfolio is done. All you have to do is save it as a portfolio and give it a name. So from the File menu, click Save Portfolio. Typically, you want to name it the same as the overall file name, as the original file, and then add the word portfolio to identify that. That's the file that you would then upload to Project Share. So let's review. In order to sign and seal a document with Adobe Sign, the document must be less than or equal to 50 megabytes and less than or equal to 99 pages. You may be able to reduce the file size by printing the document to PDF. And if that doesn't work, you can split the document into multiple parts for signing and sealing, then reassemble the parts into the single portfolio file. Thank you.